When we started the business, we started actually exporting. It was more export oriented than local sales. So when I went to the trade fairs in Europe, in USA, I was looking for customers, and it was so hard to catch a good customer. But when I made the initial contact, when they showed interest, we started building partnerships. So the main secret behind our success is that we don't have one-off businesses. We don't have one-off transactions. It's more of building relationships, building partnerships, and helping each other. So we have a customer base who are very loyal to us, who have been with us for a very long time, and who believe in what we do. So some customers we have grown together. I think in any business, the most important is to build relationships rather than just having one or two customers. At the start, we were doing what everyone else was doing. But then I realized that if I was doing what everyone else was doing, I would never have been successful. I thought I really need to do something different. This is not my business sense, it was maybe my common sense, right? So I started making different kinds of products with the fabric we wove. This was the secret where we took off. My vision was that my company should be a big family. It's not all about money and profits, right? For me personally, I'm not motivated by profit. But my motivation is to do better and for the women and the people to be benefited. This is why we got the FairTrade certification, which I think it's a big milestone in our company, and we are one of the few companies who are FairTrade guaranteed by the World FairTrade Organization. So I'm really proud that I've been able to motivate and inspire the rest who are following me or who are taking the business now to be truly committed to the social cause more than the commercial aspect of the business. It's true, the fundamental is that we are a business. We need to make profits, we need to sustain. Without profits, we will not sustain the business because we don't get any external funding and we cannot depend on people to help us. We need to think of ways and means of maximizing our profits justly and reinvesting it to the business. For 16 years, 16 long years, we never drew any dividend from the company. We solely reinvested every penny. I know it was a long, very long journey with a lot of challenges, but this concept of empowering others through economic activity has been very successful for us at Selyn. So we call ourselves a social enterprise because the motto is to impact the society in a good, meaningful way, rather than be motivated by the money we make.
Selyn ආයතනයේ දේශීය නිෂ්පාදනයේ කොටසක් වීම ගැන මම හුඟක් ආඩම්බර වෙනවා. පහසුකම් මට ලබා දීලා තියෙන උපකරණ ඒගොල්ලෝ ළඟින් පහසු මිලට ලබා දෙනවා. අපේ නිෂ්පාදන ඒගොල්ලෝ ලබා ගන්නවා. කොපමණ නිෂ්පාදනයක් වුණත් ලබා ගන්නවා.
Selyn
currently employs about 1,000 women who would never have found any other alternative income generation activities. There are skills in the villages, but the skills are not properly utilized. So at Selyn, we are giving them a platform.
මගේ ළඟ සේවිකාවන් 25 දෙනෙක් සේවය කරනවා. අපේ රෙදි වියන ගැහණු සියල්ලම වැඩට එන්නේ පයි. ටිකක් දුරින් එන අයට බයිසිකලයක් වගේ විවිධ මාර්ග අපි වඳුරාගල මහත්මියගේ උදව්ව තුලින් ලබා දුන්නා. උදාහරණයක් නම් සේවිකාවන්ට ලදරුවන් බලා ගන්න පහසුකම් ලබා දුන්නා.
Selyn is Sri Lanka's only FairTrade guaranteed company, and we've been in the World FairTrade Organization for about 8 years now. We were actually asked to join the World FairTrade Organization because that's the kind of way the principles of FairTrade, the 10 principles of FairTrade, is what we follow throughout our business. So having a FairTrade guarantee certification or an assurance is simply a way to show the world in a label about the kind of work that we do, and it is quite important. Being fair trade means that it really helps our being fair trade guaranteed, I would say, helps our company to put the structures and the requirements necessary to actually grow as a fair trade organization. Even though we've started as a fair trade organization, we had all these kind of principles. We really didn't have it embedded in our structures. We didn't have it embedded in our systems. So this certification process or this guarantee process has really helped us to do that. So one of the systems, of course, we have are the fair trade monitoring aspects in every part of our business. Because social business and fair trade is a core value in our business, that is necessary to do that, so that even if our managers come from outside, they adapt to this right from the very beginning.